here in your neighborhood, Imperial, Missouri, and we're here with Brooke Mahara. She is an interpretive resource specialist at the Mastodon State Historic Site. We're here with one of our friends. You know, he's kind of big. He's kind of big. I'm not saying that he's the biggest I've seen, but he's kind of big. And what are you holding there?
I am holding, this is actually a molar tooth from an adult Mastodon, which was the big guy behind me.
So I'm sorry, you said tooth? That's one tooth?
One tooth. It's just one molar tooth. So American mastodons would actually eat coniferous trees and shrubs and grasses that grew in this area during the Ice Age. And they needed big, bulky teeth to be able to chew at that. I mean, trees can't be that easy to chew, right? So this is one tooth from a mastodon. They would only average about 8 teeth in their mouth at a time.
Wow. Now, I guess that when they're that size, that's about all that they needed. Can you also tell us, is this a replica or is this real mastodon? Is this a real mastodon skeleton here?
It is a replica skeleton, mm-hmm. but this would be an adult male mastodon. So it's 10 feet tall. It would have been about 5.5 tons with all of his fur, muscle, and fat on uh-huh. him. We know it's a male just because the hips wouldn't be large enough for it to be a female mastodon.
Oh. Cool. How would you know that this was I guess, because I'm always interested in how scientists and archaeologists know how to put together replicas. I guess, what information did you all put together in order to build this replica?
Well, the information would have been found from previous excavations. Mm-hmm. So they had the bones from, they cast bones from those, or made the cast from those previous bones that were found and put it together to make the skeleton to look at.
Cool. Also, I see that we have this whole, it looks almost like a replica biome here. Can you tell me a little bit about the home that you think he would have had?
Yes.
Or
so
she would have had?
This was all put together from information from the archaeological and paleontological excavations from the site. So this is to depict what this area looked like towards the end of the Ice Age. So we have various trees and plants because we found pollen samples in our excavations, and that's how we were able to determine which of these, what the environment was like here. So we know that this area was primarily a coniferous forest. It was uh-huh. more open. Our site here is towards the end of the Ice Age, so mm-hmm. the environment is changing. The plants are starting to change over to more deciduous forests. That's why we've got some leafy trees in there.
And what's the difference between the two different types of forests?
It's just the cooler environment, so it was much cooler at that time. So the coniferous trees tend to be, and if you think about northern parts of the United States, have a lot more of those coniferous trees with mm-hmm. the needles. And, you know, more of us southern, we have more of those deciduous trees.
Oh, okay. See, I learned so much just now. And if you want to learn so much and also impress your friends on Monday morning, spend the weekend here at the Mastodon State Historic Site, 1050 Charles J. Becker Drive in Imperial, mostateparks.com. We have some serious dentists down here in your neighborhood, Imperial, on the 9 a.m. show.